Welcome students. Today we will see exercise 14.4 in that question number 1. The following distribution gives the daily income of 50 workers of a factory. Here the daily income is in rupees he has given and number of workers he has given. That is 12 number of workers are in the range of 100 to 120 rupees. 14 workers are there, they are in 120 to 140 rupees of daily income. Now convert this distribution. Above this distribution we have to convert to less than type cumulative frequency. We have observed in the last exercise, that is LIC policy problem you have done, that is less than 60 years, less than 10 years of age, number of policy like that we have done. Here cumulative frequency, like that we have to convert this into less than type of cumulative frequency distribution and draw its ogive. Here ogive is nothing but it's a graph. We have to draw the distribution graph. Now here first I'll write this one, this table I'll write in this form first. Here this is I written here. Here I have written this table and daily wages, the same thing whatever he has given I have written here. 100 to 120 12 numbers, 120 to 140 14, 140 to 168, 160 to 186 and 180 to 200 it is 10. Now the third column I have added, that is cumulative frequency, because we have to convert it into less than type means we have to first calculate this one, cumulative frequency. Now here this we have to write as it is, that is 26. 26 plus 8 34, 34 plus 6 40, 40 plus 10 50. Here sigma fi is equal to 50, that is the summation of these frequencies. Now here we have to convert this one into less than type. Here less than type means here you observe this is 100 to 120 means we can write this as less than 120. Less than 120. How many frequencies it is there? That is 12. And here we can write less than 140. Here less than 140, how many are there? That is 14 and 12. Both we have to add because 26 numbers they are there. Here 26 numbers which are less than 140 means it includes less than 120 also. Okay. So in the same way, less than 160, that is equal to, here this is 34, because 8 plus 14 plus 12, all are including here, 34. Less than 160 means it may be 160, 140, 120, 100, like this. Here in this way, this 34. Less than 180, that is equal to 40. And here less than 200, that is equal to 50. Okay, this I will write neatly here, I will put it in a table. Table I have written in this way. Here less than 120, here it is 12. Less than 140, this is 26 here. Less than 160, this is 34. Less than 180, 40. And less than 200, it is equal to 50. The same thing I have written. Whatever I have explained here, in that way I have written here. Now we have converted this one. Okay. We have converted this to a less than type. So for that, for conversion of less than type, what we have to do? We have to first calculate the cumulative frequency. So that it will be very easy to write this one. Now we have to plot this one on x-axis and we have to plot this one as a y-axis. That is number of here daily wages. Daily wages we can plot it into x-axis, okay, and number of workers can be plotted in y-axis. I have plotted this one like this. I'll put here. Here the same thing, this table data I have put it in a graph, that is in ogive. This is a distribution graph. This is a frequency distribution graph. Okay. Now here daily income I have taken in a x-axis and the number of workers I have plotted in y-axis. Here up to 100 it is lengthy one, so hence it is from 100 only it is started here. Less than 120 means 120 point, at 120 means less than 120 there are 12. Here there are 12 number of workers are here. 12 number of workers are. Okay. At 140, that is 26. Here this is 26. Okay. This is 26. 26 and this is 12. And here this is 34. Okay. This is 34. In this way. And we have considered here 40. Okay. This is 40. And this is 50 here. This point. And here 120, 140, 160, 180, 200 here. This is the frequency distribution. Okay, this is the graph. That's what he has asked. Draw its ogive. that is frequency distribution graph. Okay, we'll go for next one. Exercise 14.4 in that question number 2. During the medical checkup of 35 students of a class, their weights were recorded as follows. Here, that is less than 38, no students are there. Less than 43, number of students are there. In this way, the weights have been recorded. Draw a less than type OGV for a given data. Here, he has given OGV, that is already he has given. And hence, obtain the median weight from the graph and verify the result by using the formula. Here, theoretically, that is by using the formula, theoretically also we have to calculate the median, and graphically also we have to calculate. This is graphically also we have to calculate. First we have to plot this one in a diagram, that is OGV, as he has given already directly less than type only. Hence we have to first draw a graph. From that graph we have to find out the median weight. And after that, the same thing has to be calculated by as usual method, that what we are calculating in the last exercises. That is by using the formula, that is theoretically. Now I will plot a graph, this one. Here, we have to take this weight in kgs in the x-axis and the number of students in y-axis. This is x-axis and this is y-axis. Here, this way, in this way, this is x-axis. And this is y-axis. Here we have taken weight in kgs. Okay. And here number of students. Number of students. Here what we have to do? We have to see 38 and here 40. Like this we have to make marking here. 40, 42 here. And here up to 52. And here this is from 0 to 3, 9. Okay. Up to this 35. The graph has been plotted. The values, that is the weights in kgs in x-axis and number of students in y-axis, I have plotted in this graph. Here less than 38, here this is 38 is 0. Less than 40, here it is equal to 3, here this is 3, like this. Okay. Now, the same thing, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50 and 52. They have been plotted here, 3 and 5 here. This is 5 and 9 here and 14, 28, 32 and 35. Last 35 here. Okay. This is 52 and 35. In this way, the graph has been plotted here. Now, what we have to do? Graphically, we have to calculate the median weight. That is from the graph. Here, how to calculate this median weight? Here, we have to first calculate that sigma fi. Sigma fi is equal to what? Here, the maximum term here. This is 35. That is less than 52 means it will cover all these. That is sigma fi is equal to 35. Okay. This is equal to n. And n by 2 is nothing but what? That is equal to 35 divided by 2, which is equal to 17.5. We have to mark this 17.5 here. Okay. And here we have to extend, or we have to draw a parallel line parallel to x-axis, and which will cut this curve at this point. Now we have to draw a perpendicular line from x-axis here, like this. This is like this. This is this value. This is equal to, this value is equal to approximately 46.5. And this is the median weight. And this is the median weight, that is equal to 46.5. In this way we can calculate here. First we have to calculate sigma fi, and after that is n by 2 we have to calculate, which is equal to 17.5, and that 17.5 we have to extend to the up to this curve, and from that we have to draw a perpendicular line on the x-axis. Whatever the value we will get here, that is the median weight of the students. Now we have to calculate theoretically. For calculating the theoretically, we have to convert this table into as usual table, that is from the ranges table. After that, we have to calculate by using the formula. Okay. Here, the same thing I have written here, less than 32, less than 38 is equal to 0, 43, 42, 5, like this I have written. This I have converted into classes, that is 0 to 38. How many? That is 0. Less than 30 means what? that is 38 to 40 we have to calculate. 38 to 40, how many are there? There are 3, because this 3 minus 0, that is equal to 3. And 40 to 42, that is 40 to 42, in this range, here 3 to 5, means this minus this, okay, that is 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2. And 42 to 44, here 9 minus 5, okay, whatever the remaining, that will be 4. 44 to 46, okay, here, this one, and this is 14 minus 9, because less than 44 means, this is what, 9 numbers are there here. 9 numbers means, here, less than 44. Less than 46 and above 44, that will be 14 minus 9, that is 5. In this way, we have to calculate here. And whatever the values you are getting, they are FIs. Those FIs, of course, there the summation will be equal to 35 only. Because whatever the highest, that is less than 52, is the summation of all this. Hence, the sigma Fi is equal to 35. Now, we have to calculate the cumulative frequency here. Cumulative frequency, how to calculate? This is, here, this is cumulative frequency. For this, here, first one, I have to write here 0 only. And here, this is 0 plus 3. 0 plus 3 equal to 3. And here, this 3 plus 2, that is 3 plus 2 equal to 5. And 5 plus 4 equal to 9. 9 plus 5 here. This is 9 plus 5. This is equal to 14. And 14 plus 14 is equal to 28. And here 28 plus 4 is equal to 32. And here 32 plus 3 is equal to 35. These are the cumulative frequencies. And here median class also we have to calculate here first. Median class here, which is equal to, here first you see n is equal to what? N is equal to, that is 35. N is equal to 35 means n by 2 is equal to 17.5. Here you see 17.5 is in between this 14 and 28. That is in this. This is median class. Here 28 lies in the 17.5. Okay, up to 14 only this is there. And after that 14 to 28 it is. That will be, this 17.5 comes under 14 to 28. Hence this median class will be 46 to 48. This is the median class. And here L is the lower limit of the median class, means this is equal to 46. Okay, here n we have calculated, that is equal to 35, and n by 2 is equal to 17.5, I will write here, and L also we have calculated, and after that, here cumulative frequency is nothing but what, here this is the median class means this, before that, prior to that is equal to 14, and frequency F, it is given by here, what is this, here this is 14, 14 is the frequency of the median class. That is 14. F is equal to 14. Now, H is the class interval. Class interval means 48 minus 46. This is equal to 2. Now, we will substitute these values in the median. The formula for median is equal to, median is equal to L plus N by 2 minus cumulative frequency divided by frequency into H. Here, L means what? 46 plus N by 2. That is 17.5. Minus cumulative frequency is 14 divided by frequency is equal to 14 into 4. Here H is equal to, this is 2. Okay, this is 2. Now here 46 plus 17.5 minus 14 means 3.5 into 2 means 7. 7 divided by 14, that is 1 by 2. This is 46 plus 0.5. This is equal to 46.5. This is the median. Okay. This is theoretical value, and you can compare this with this practical value. That is also equal to 46.5. Okay. Hence, both the values, that is whether theoretically or graphically, both are correct. Okay, we will go for next one. Exercise 14.4, in that question number 3. The following table gives production yield per hectare of wheat of 100 farms of village. That is number of farms. This is sigma Fi he has given. That is equal to 100. Production yield 50 to 55, 55 to 60, like this he has given. Change the distribution to a more than type distribution. Earlier we have seen that is less than type. Here we have to convert this into more than type distribution and draw its value. Now here I will plot it on a table now. The same data I have written in this form, in the vertical form. That is production yield kg per hectare 50 to 55, it is number of forms are 2. And here, like this, 55 to 60, 8. 75 to 80, there are 16. Sigma Fi, this is total. Summation is equal to 100. Now here, I'll write, this is production yield, same thing. Here, kg per hectare. And here, more than type, I have to convert. This one, I have to convert it into more than type. Here, this I will plot it in a x-axis, and this I will plot it in a y-axis, for this whatever. And here, this is number of farms. Number of farms. Okay. This is FR, of course. Here, more than here, what I have to write? More than 50. Okay. This is what? More than 50. More than 50, how many are there? Total are there. Okay. These are all more than. Okay. This is equal to 100. And here, more than, this is more than what? 55. Okay. More than 55 means from this to total. Means in 100 we have to subtract this previous one. 100 minus 2. This is equal to 98. And here more than 60. More than 60 is equal to what? Here total how many are there? Here there. More than 60. This total minus 10. Okay. This total minus 10. Or otherwise this total minus this one. Here more than 60 means we have to subtract, this total is 100. In that 100, we have to subtract these two. That is 10. Here, you can write 90. Or otherwise, this also can be written as this 98, whatever here it is there, you have got this 98 up to this. 98 minus 8, you have to subtract. That is also equal to, that is 98 minus 8 also you can write, that is 90. And here, more than 65, I'll write 100 minus what? More than 65 means this is total minus this one. 12 plus 2, 12 plus 8, 8 plus 2. That is 22. Is equal to here what? 78. Or otherwise, this is easy. That is 90 minus 12. Here this 90 minus 12 also you can write. Here more than 70. More than 70 how to write? This total, that is 100 minus the total previous one. 24 plus 12. 24 plus 12, 36, 36, 44, 46. This is 100 minus 46. This is equal to what? 54. Okay. Here more than 75. 100 minus this total, 38 plus. Here total how much it is? This is 38 plus 50, 62, 64, 74 plus 84. Here 100 minus 84. This is equal to 16. Here this also can be written as, here 78 minus 24 also we can write. 78 minus, this is 24. 78 minus 24. And here you can write 54 minus 38. Okay. In this way also you can write here. Only one thing you can follow. And here this will be the production yield is plotted. This is plotted in the x-axis and this is plotted in y-axis. Okay. So now I will plot this one. Total I will write as, here more than 50 is equal to 100 and here more than 55 is 98, more than 60 is 90 and more than 65 is 78 and more than 70 is 54, more than 75 is 16. Okay. This I will plot in x-axis and this I will plot in y-axis. Now I will plot this one. Now here I have plotted this one, that is here number of farms I have written. Okay, here this is y-axis and here production yield. This is production yield in kg per hectare. For this more than 50, here more than 50 means this point and here this is 100. More than 55, that is 98. More than 60, it is 90. Okay, this is 90 here. And in this way, this is 78, 54, and this is 16. For 75, it will be 16. Okay, in this way, the graph has been plotted. This is the distribution graph. Okay, thank you.